Now the herbs I'm going to use for this first dish are two herbs, one of which is lavender and the other one's mint. Now you'll be familiar with mint, but lavender in cooking, particularly with this dish, lamb, it works perfect. And obviously we're going to do a classic mint sauce. So first things first, I'll talk about the lavender later on. We've got in here our lovely lamb. Now like I said, this marketplace used to sell loads and loads of sheep, up to about 80,000 sheep a year in this marketplace alone. Sadly, that's died down a bit now, but we've got this lovely leg of lamb from our local butchers just around the corner. Beautiful half leg. Now you can use a whole leg if you wanted to. Another nice cut to look out for is the shoulder. But what you can do, first of all, is just using a really sharp knife, and use like a small paring knife if you've got one, just insert your knife all over the leg of lamb. Now on a piece like this, you're looking at doing it about 10 different places, just randomly, all over the surface, and put your knife in about an inch down, right the way through the skin. And I say, if you're using a shoulder, it's exactly the same process. So we've got our leg of lamb there. Now there's a few ingredients that we're going to put in here. There's a little bit of garlic, and what I've done is just peel the garlic and cut this into thin sort of slivers of garlic, just peeled, thinly sliced, and that's going to be inserted into our little holes that we've got in our lamb. So just take your finger and press these slivers of garlic inside. Now obviously that classic combination of garlic and lamb works perfectly well, but you can pack it full of flavour as well. That's one of the great things about lamb, it's quite a robust flavour and it takes quite strong flavours to go with it, particularly like mint sauce and in particular garlic. So press it in really well. Now as well as stud this with garlic, what I'm actually going to do is place a little bit of lavender in there. I've got this from one of the stalls. If you grow this in your garden and you're going to do this dish, snip off the little heads that go on there, the little purple heads, before you place it into the lamb. Those are used for sort of desserts. You can crystallise and put them on sort of fruit toppings and cake toppings, but catch it before it flowers, or trim off those purple tops and then insert this, just a little sprig inside each little hole. Now it's quite strong as lavender, so you only need a little bit, so just place a little sprig of the lavender inside each hole where you've put the garlic. Again, make sure it's nice and compact, there we go, and you've got this lovely combination of garlic and lavender. So to roast this off, very straightforward, just take our pan. Now unlike most meats which you would seal beforehand, you don't need to with this, obviously, because the garlic and the lavender will burn. So just simply take our piece of meat, season it with a generous amount of salt, some black pepper over the top, make sure it's nicely coated in that salt and pepper, taking some oil to place over the top just to help it a little, but it also stops the next ingredient from burning, because what I'm going to place on here now is some honey. Now like I said, you can actually buy lavender honey. A lot of the farms in the Dales will actually have lavender farms, beautiful, beautiful aromas and smells, and generally next door to it you'll have sort of beekeepers selling their honey, but you've got this lovely honey here which we can just spoon this over the top. Now don't worry about placing it all over the top, just a good spoonful, because obviously as it's cooking that honey will then fall off, and while it's cooking we need to baste that, keep basting it over the top of the lamb, and the oil that's in there should stop the honey from burning. So what I'm going to do now is pass that to Catherine. There we go. We're going to stick that in the little van, little oven. Now at home, about 200 degrees centigrade for about an hour, that's size of lamb. If it's a whole leg of lamb, about an hour and a half, no more than that. Now obviously the classic ingredient to go with lamb is mint sauce. We've got in here these lovely little pots of mint, not what you would normally buy. You would normally buy the mint like this, loose, maybe in a supermarket or at your veg producer, but we've got in here these little plants. But we've got this lovely mint here, which I'm going to chop up and just do a classic mint sauce. Now, even though I've trimmed off most of the leaves on this, this plant will still continue to grow. So just keep that on your windowsill or pot it in your garden. It'll be perfectly all right. It'll continue to regrow. So our lovely mint here, stems and all, I put in my mint sauce. My granny taught me how to make this when I was a young kid. And she never used to pick off all the leaves. The stems used to go in as well. The whole lot gets chopped up on your board. It's a lovely fresh and instant flavour, and it takes very, very little time to do. So rather than make a big batch and store it, make it when you need it. This mint grows all year round. It's perfect. So chop up your mint like that. While I'm chopping that one up, just pan on the stove here. And we're just going to warm up a little bit of water. Just a touch of water and go in our pan. And then we can add some salt and some sugar. Now, the reason why I'm warming it up just a little bit is A, to infuse the mint, but B, to dissolve the sugar and the salt that we're going to put in there. So place the salt in there and the sugar. Again, if you put too much sugar in, you can always compensate it with a little bit more vinegar. We chop this up. And this is the bit that you just need to take care of. We can then take our mint, place it into our pan. Try not to overcook it at this stage. All you're going to do is just infuse it, a bit like you infuse all the flavour out of tea. Just infuse it a little bit. And then the final ingredient is, of course, some white wine vinegar. Again, this is purely to taste, really. So pop the vinegar in, gently warm it up. Now, don't boil it at this stage, otherwise the mint just turns brown and goes horrible. So all you're going to do is just gradually just infuse it through. So at this point, you can have a quick taste. Nearly there, just a little bit more vinegar, I think. Just gradually warm it up, and that's our lovely mint sauce. Leave it to stand there while our lamb, which is here, which the old dog wants, thank you very much, Catherine. Now, with our roast leg of lamb that we've got here, nice and pink in the middle, what you need to do, and I was taught from a young little kid from about 6 years old, as my father said, cooking is very, very simple. Very, very simple. A bit like the piece of meat. He said, you leave it to rest before you eat it. And that's the big, big tip when you, particularly with roast meats, in particular chicken, lamb, pork, beef, whatever meat you're cooking, and game as well, because it can be quite tough, is just allow it to rest slightly before you carve it all up. So what we can do now is then carve this up, which you can see that lovely colour that you get on this lamb because of the honey, and that combination of honey and oil will stop that from burning and give it a nice little glaze. All we can now do is just take a knife, and we can carve this up. There we go. Right the way through. Again, allow it to rest. You can see the little bits of garlic and lavender in there. Again, if you want it well done, piece of meat like this, about an hour and a half, pink, how I like it, no more than an hour in the oven, we're perfectly all right. To serve this, grab our plate. We've got, take our lovely pieces of sliced lamb. With this, all I'm gonna do is serve it with a little bit of buttered carrots. So taking some butter into our pan, some nice fresh carrots, which you can see in there, just a touch of salt, doesn't want too much, don't bother with parsley, it doesn't matter, just a touch of carrots on the side. There we go, and a good spoonful of our mint sauce on the side. And there we have it. Lamb with mint sauce and buttered carrots.